Hey guys, Kat Kerr. I am so excited about these. These are like a dream come true. And I have been wanting to make these for such a long time. And thanks to Barb over at Joggles.com, she has always been so open and gracious and just willing to listen to some of my ideas. And I so appreciate that. And I am not gonna lie, when I got these in the mail, oh my gosh, I just about fell off of my chair because they are so large and so detailed and they're etched so nice and deep, and I love them. I absolutely love them. I think I texted her about 4 times and I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't believe they're in my hands. And so I am so thrilled to be sharing these with you. These are really from they're images from past assemblages that I created. And so I am super excited about them. And today I'm going to share some journal pages with you, but please make sure that you subscribe because I have quite a few videos planned where I'm not only going to show you how to use them in your journals, but to also make dimensional work with them, whether it's some 3D layering pieces, some assemblages. You can definitely use these in a lot of different ways. So thanks for being here. Thanks, Barb, for listening, and let's get started. Now, today I'm going to be making some disbound journal pages, but before I get started, I wanted to address how I'm going to use the stamps. With stamps this large, my first gut reaction was to take out my stamping platform, but then I thought, what if you don't have a stamping platform? An easy fix is to use a piece of clear craft plastic and just tape it to your work surface and attach your cling stamp and then add some ink and press it onto your page. This is a great solution for large stamps, especially because you don't always get that crisp first image, and a lot of times you need to re-ink, and so this ensures that you are going to be stamping in the same exact spot, and it's a great idea for not only big stamps but for small stamps as well. Now, naturally, you can also use an acrylic block or just use the stamp as is to add your image. So now that I've added these designs to some journal pages, let's go ahead and finish them up.